To use the wall tool, we're going to click on the wall tool here within the 1001 bit tools. And every time you use one of these tools, an interface will pop up. It gives us a little description and diagram. And here now we can type in the variables. So let's just assume that the thickness is 6 inches and that the wall height is 9 feet. We're going to have it build as a group. So this is kind of nice. It's already going to essentially draw the rectangle, push it up, and group it for us. So it's kind of scripting and batching, batch processing sort of all the intricate clicks that we tell it to. For wall alignment, that really just depends on the way that we're tracing. So if we're tracing on the right, then the path is going to be on the right side and the wall is going to go on the left. So I want to trace this right now. In this model, I'm just going to trace this clockwise. So I want to stay to the right. We'll go ahead and click Build Wall. Our cursor is going to be a little plus sign. And at every click, it's going to create an intersection. So the trick here is it doesn't lock automatically in that axis. So that's why we created the guides originally, so that now it can just sort of touch every endpoint. Now, the only downside is it doesn't lock to the red axis. So you do have to hover over the origin point, move your cursor over, and you'll feel that sort of click into place. So I'm going to click there. I'm going to click here. I'm going to click back up. And then I'm going to accidentally click somewhere. So if you accidentally click, there's no undo here. You basically have to start over. So I'm going to press Escape. And I'm going to start back over from the beginning. So every click is going to create an intersection. And then if I either click back to the endpoint, it's going to create that loop, which of course this isn't what I want. Or when you get to an endpoint that you want to finish at, just double click. So I'll go down to here, bring this over, bring this back up, back to here. And then right here, I'm going to double click. So now with the wall created, I'm just going to orbit around here to look at it from this way. It's essentially just created this all as its own separate group. So use this to your advantage. If you have other rooms, like maybe this wall, we needed to maybe demo at certain point. I may only push pull it to here. Or use the wall tool to there, because then I can create a new wall from here and have this go down to here and double click. So sometimes I'll create separate walls for separate pieces. That way you have control later on of what you want that to be. Now for ours, let's just keep it how we had it. And another thing is if you accidentally push pull this piece and maybe you double clicked at the wrong spot and it does sort of something like that. So maybe it looks like that. Just remember that it is a wall that you can double click inside of. So I'll take the select tool, double click in that object. I'll take the line tool and I'll just create a break. So I'm just breaking this top surface. And then that way I can just push this down to carve it away. Also, this wall extends. So I'll just take push pull and I'll extend it a little bit longer. Maybe another 9 feet. So the key here is I'm only trying to model the dining room and the living room. I'm not worrying about the kitchen here, and I'm not worrying about this adjacent wall. So when I view into the model, my perspective view is going to be something like this. So I don't have to worry about the entire adjacent spaces within this model here. In our next video, let's take a look at creating the window in the space here.